Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to modify, fix or improve a robot program created in RoboDK. Let's get started. So here we have the program we quickly created in the last video. It's on purpose, full of errors. As you can see here, it's not following the curve in any meaningful way. Same here. Here we are going in this direction and then here, so that doesn't make sense. So there's a few things that needs to be fixed. First of all, I want to show you a little trick. So if you double click on the robot program, as you might see right now, we have a slider that appears at the bottom of your screen. So if I was to close that here, double click program, there's a slider that appears right here that I can use to scroll through the program. On the other hand, if I right click and select run, the same slider doesn't appear, but the robot still run the program. So that can be useful in different situations. So if you just want to record a little something for a customer or for someone in general, and you don't want to see the slider, that's a great thing to be able to just right click and run and not have any slider. But here, what we want to do is actively debug our program and understand why it's not working the way we want it or were expecting. So in this case, I did some errors in, let's say, voluntarily, but it's generally not the case. So you generally need to have the slider to scroll down. Another thing here, it's a bit too fast for me to see anything meaningful, so I'm gonna slow it down a bit. If you feel like it's still too fast, you can always just double click the robot, go parameters, and then change the speed of the robot. So in this case, I'll bring it down to 100. We will, in a future video, discuss robot speed, acceleration, and everything, but that's a whole topic in itself. So if I run it now, perfect, goes at 100 millimeters per second, that makes sense. Gonna make simulation speed just a bit faster. Cool. So one thing to notice is that if you take the slider, it will show you which step is currently being executed. So you can see potentially this way, which ones are problematic. So here we can see around cutting 6 and cutting 7, we should have a move C. Same around cutting 9, cutting 10, we should have a move C. And if we come closer, starting from here, we go directly to our point 13, and then I'm gonna make that invisible so that you can better see the station tree. By the way, I will talk about that later, but if you want the station tree to be opaque, you can go tool option and then here display tree preference and bring it opaque. I personally always have it that way. There's some drawback with that method. I have punched another method that I could show you guys. We could discuss that. We will discuss that later in the training. So anyway, there's some little thing that needs to be fixed here. First of all, this point here, which is like target 13, if we bring the naming, if we bring the naming and if we press minus a few times, we would see that here we have target cutting 13, which in fact should be our first target that is here. So what we'll do is just take cutting 13 and bring it at the first position. Sometimes it's a bit hard to figure out where the first position is. One good trick is to right click, hold and drop. This way you can decide to go before, after or nested. So it's gonna be before in this case here. Okay, so if I rerun the program like that, so that's already something kind of fixed. So I have a starting point here, cutting point one here, and then going here. As you can see, I'm using move L, then move J, then move L again. I would generally wanna have all move L's in this case here. So I'm gonna change the first one to the second one for a move L here. So I'm going cutting 13, cutting one, and then cutting two, blah, 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 up to cutting 13 here. In this case, it's not necessary, but from cutting 12, I could want to have a real point at cutting one before going to cutting 14, which is behind my tool here. If I bring the robot back to home, you'll see it. So right click, move home. I have my cutting 14 here. So let's say that I want to really pass through cutting one before going to cutting 14. What I can do is simply select my move L cutting one, control C, and then select the last cutting point, cutting 14, and then control V. So that will simply copy and paste the motion I just selected. Just like that, if I rerun this program here, oops, I need to go to the first position here, otherwise I'm hitting a singularity. So I'm double clicking on the first target here, and then I'm running this path, and apart from the two rounded points, the rest seems to be cool. No, just a small issue here. Cutting one should be before cutting 14. Excellent, so just like that, cool. Now, another thing that I wanna show you, you can select these one by one to run the program step by step. So I'm double clicking on each one after the other, to go from one point to the other. So that's also very valuable when it comes the time to select or to debug, so that you can really go through the different points one by one. I'm gonna hide the naming. Another thing that I wanna show you, in this case, we don't have that many targets, so it's kind of, let's say, manageable, but imagine that you have like 100 more targets. And you want to see which target it is that is like linked with cutting six. So you can right click and select target. It will bring you to the target that is linked. In this case here, like I said, we just have 14 targets, so that's not that hard to figure out which target is with it, which target. But if you had like 12 frames and they are all collapsed and there's like hundreds of targets, that can be really useful. Then you can select this one here, either click on it to see it or right click and then reframe on, and it will bring the window with this target right in the center. Okay. Next thing I need to do is modify those linear motions here to create some curved motion or circular motion for those little pieces here. So what I'll do is I'll use my slider to figure out which motion is problematic. So in this case, this one here, up to move 5, that's fine. Move 6 and move 7 should be removed and replaced by a move C. So what I can do is select move C and select move 7, move 6 and move L7. I can delete those. Now I need to add the move L right here, I need to add the move C right here. So what I can do is select the instruction just before where I want the move C to be added. Then I can select my target 6 and target 7. Remember, if you want to add a circular motion, you need to add the intermediary point and the final point, as we've learned in a previous video. And then you can select add circular motion. It was added just right here. And as you can see, it was added right after the selected motion. So I can do the same here for this one. And then I can remove move L9 and 10. Can select move L8, hold control, select 9, select target 10, and add a circular motion, just like that. And if I run the program now, I have the exact shape of the path I was looking for. Just like that. Cool. So that's how you can kind of work your way in a program to fix, improve, remove stuff that was either automatically created or created by you. If you remember the first example, I showed you how to kind of just quickly click on the lines, telling you that I was going to show you that later. those are automated method. They create a program the same way as you would do if you were to create it manually, but with some tools. So if there is no difference between a program that has like 10 points or 10,000 points, so that's a cool part. But you still have the flexibility to modify it manually later down the road if you need to, kind of just make things exactly the way you need them. So it's important for you to know that you can do those kind of modifications. So either right click, change the type of motion, remove some motion, obviously, use the scroll here to figure out which target is currently, or which instruction is currently being executed, and to add motions exactly where you want in the program. In the next video, we will learn how to duplicate programs. So take that program here and create a copy of it just to the side without having to recreate every targets in it. So there is a cool way to use frames in this case to really streamline your work and reduce by a great margin the time you'll have to invest in your projects. So hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.